factor polynomials which look like these, where a, b, and c are some numbers. We'll start with the simplest cases, where a is equal to 1. Here's our first example. And let's begin by working backwards. We'll start with the answer. It's the quantity of x plus 3 times the quantity of x plus 1. Let's multiply. Then, we'll combine the like terms. We'll see that we've gotten back to where we started from. We found the factors of 3, when added together, equal 4. Generalizing, we found the factors of the C term, when added together, equal the B term. Here's our second example. Remember what to look for. We want the factors of the C term that add up to the B term. In this case, the factors of C, or 6, adding up to B, 5. Let's list those factors. 1 and 6, 6 and 1, 3 and 2, and 2 and 3. Adding these together, well, the 6 and the 1s will get us 7, and the 3s and the 2s, those will get us 5. We can see that the 6 and the 1s won't work. They don't add up to 5, but the 2s and the 3s do. We'll use these in our proposed factored form. We'll check these by multiplying again. We see it does check. One more example should work. We are looking for, once again, the factors of C which add up to the B term. In this case, we want the factors of 12 which add up to 7. We'll start by listing these factors. 1 and 12, 12 and 1, 2 and 6, 6 and 2, 3 and 4, and 4 and 3. Then we'll add. We can immediately see that 12 and 1 add up to 13. Those won't work. The 6s and the 2s will add up to 8. These won't work. And we can see that the 3s and the 4s adding up to 7 will be the ones we'll use. We'll place the 3s and the 4s in our factored form. Then again, we'll multiply to see if this checks. It works.